Hi everyone. In previous class we saw about properties of multiplication of integers, closure property and commutative property. Okay. Today we are going to learn about the third property, associative property. Associative property. The definition: for any three integers a comma b comma c, so a into b into c equal to a into b into c. Okay, so here, listen here. We take any three integers a comma b comma c. Okay, a into b into c equal to a into b into c. Dear students, how to read this one? First, a into b into c equal to a into b into c. Okay. Why here the bracket here keep? So first we find the solution, the bracket inside values. Okay. After we go to find the next integer value. Okay. Okay dear students, once again, for any three integers a comma b comma c, so a into b into c equal to a into b into c. These two sides also equal. Okay. So this property is known as associative property. Okay. So let us see the example sum. Example 1.22. Prove that minus 2 into 3 into minus 4 equal to minus 2 into 3 into minus 4. Okay. So we take the left hand side solution. LHS. Left hand side equal to minus 2 into 3. Into minus 4. First we find the solution left hand side. Okay. First we find a solution, the bracket inside values. Yes or no? Yes. Okay. So minus 2 into 3. 2 into 3. 2 3 is 6. So minus into plus. Minus 6. Okay. Minus 6. Okay. And minus 4. Minus 4. Okay. Now 6 fours are 24. 6 fours are 24. Minus into minus plus. So plus 24 we can write 24 only. Okay. So left hand side equal to 24. Now we take the right hand side values. Right hand side. So RHS equal to minus 2 into 3 into minus 4. 3 into minus 4. Okay. So first we find the answer bracket inside values. Okay. So minus 2 into 3 fourths are 12. 3 fourths are 12. So plus into minus. Minus. Plus into minus. You know very well, plus into minus. Minus. Okay. Now 2 into 12. 12 2s are 24. The total 12 2s are 24. Minus into minus plus. So plus 24 we can write 24. So the RHS equal to 24. Okay. Now left hand side equal to that 4. Left hand side equal to right hand side. Yes or no? Yes. So the two sides also equal. The answer 24 and here also 24. Therefore, minus 2 into 3. Minus 2 into 3 into minus 4 equal to minus 2 into 3 into minus 4. Okay, the two sides also we get the same answer, 24. Yes or no? Yes. So the two sides also equal. So it is a what property? This property, it is a associative property. So it is a associative property. It is a associative property. Associative property. Associative property. Okay. Okay. the question, the two sides also we get the same answer. The two sides also equal. Okay, so this property is known as associative property. So once again, for any three integers a comma b comma c, a into b into c equal to a into b into c. This property is known as associative property. Okay, so now we go to the next property. Okay, the fourth property, multiplicative identity. Okay, multiplicative identity. Okay, so let us see the definition. For any integer a, for any integer a, so a into 1 equal to 1 into a equal to a into 1 equal to 1 into a equal to a. Okay, so we take any one integer and multiply by 1 and the reverse order, 1 into a, so we get the same integer, same answer. Okay, for example, now a equal to 5, a equal to 5. Now we check the this property. So a into 1, a into 1. So a, so the value of the a equal to 5. So 5 into 1, 5 into 1 equal to 1 into 5. 5 into 1 equal to 1 into 5 equal to, what is the answer? 5 only, yes or no? Okay, so therefore this property a into 1 equal to 1 into a equal to a, so this property is known as multiplicative identity. Okay dear students, in this class we saw about associative property and multiplicative identity. Okay, remaining we will see next class. Thank you.